टुडे प्रोफेसर डॉक्टर मनोज कुमार विल टॉक व्हाट आर द फ्यूचर रिसर्च डायरेक्शन इन द बिल्डिंग वेयर द रिसर्च डायरेक्शन कैन बी यूज्ड वेयर द पीएचडी स्कॉलर एमटेक स्कॉलर एंड द बीटेक प्रोजेक्ट इन द बिल्डिंग कैन बी डन व्हाट वेयर द बिल्डिंग कैन बी डन this direction, research direction will be helpful for the all the BTech student for preparing the project, MTech student for preparing the project, and the PhD scholar is current for the preparing the project. Hence, abstract of the paper is the recently weight reduction of the car bodies to reduce the environmental load substance and workability in improvement to enhance the international competitiveness have made progress in the field of the automotive material. Automotive materials are progressing day by day due to the reduce the environmental load substance, the reduction of the car body weight are the improving day by day. Under such circumstances, steel materials are required to have super high tensile strength and to be able to deal with the complex structure of the part with the high performance. In the field of the thick plate and the steel pipe, trend of the mega structural construction and the high efficiency transportation lead to the steep demand of the thick and the high tensile strength steel products. To fully utilize such advanced steel products, the innovation of the welding technology are necessary, and the various welding technology have been developed and applied with the progress of the steel material. This paper introduces the development and the actual application of the state of the art welding technology in the GE group. Introduction. In application of the steel material, while development of the steel material is the solely important progress in the welding technology, making good use of the advanced steel material is also necessary and indispensable. In recent years, high tensile strength steels have progressively replaced mild steel, as exemplified by increasing application of the ultra high strength steels, and the tendency of this innovation has been conducted with managing compensated formability and weldability of the selected material. Progress in the welding technology adopting these material is strongly demanded in order to make the best use of these high tensile strength steel and establish a global position of the technical superior. The requirements in the automotive field are extremely stringent. In that, the weldability of the high tensile strength material by the various welding methods, such as resistant exposed welding, arc welding, laser welding, etc., must be on the same level as that of the mild steel, and at the same time, joint strength corresponding to the higher strength of the base metal must be secured. And the corrosion resistance, crack resistance, and other property must be satisfied in the same conventional process. In the field of the thick plates, high strength heavy gauge steel products are increasingly adopted in response to the trends towards the large scale container ships and the taller high rise building. Accompanying these trends, in the past several years, high efficiency welding technology with high heat input have been developed for the high strength heavy gauge plate, such as a YP460 in the shipbuilding field and HBL 345 and HBL 440 in the construction. Although the thick material of the 80 to 100 mm in the thickness have been demanded recently, it is still not possible to satisfy joint property and weldability with the conventional one-pass high-heat input welding technology. Therefore, the development of the new low-heat input welding technology and development of the high-performance welding consumable is demanded. With regard to the welded steel pipes, improved welding efficiency in the pipe manufacturing is strongly demanded in order to meet the increased demand for the heavy gauge. High-strength steel pipes for the application emerged with the improvement of the transportation efficiency, environmental countermeasures, and the development of the oil fields in the deep water, driven by the high level of activity in the energy field. This paper presents an overview of the recent development in the welding technology against the background outlined above. In the automotive field, the development of the new welding technology and improvement of the weldability are discussed. And in plate and the steel pipe fits, narrow gauge welding technology and the new welding consumable for the high heat input welding correspond to the use of the thick material and the recent progress in the multiple electrode submerged arc welding, which is a welding technology for the UF pipe, are introduced. An important aspect of the welding technology, techniques for the improvement of the fatigue strength, recent welding technology and quality assurance technology are also discussed, and the current status of the main welding automation technology, which have been applied practically in the J engineering, is reviewed. Status of technology developed in the automotive field. In resistance sport welding in the automotive field, in addition to ensuring the negative diameter and obtaining the targeted strength of the joint, the welding process must also be the robust. With the trend toward the high strength steel material, the combination of dodge sheets are sheets to are also increasingly diverse, and depending on the design, sheets to join may rather become thicker in some cases. In such cases, welding of the three-sheet lap joint consisting of the thick structure member and outer panel is required, and formation of the stable nuggets become difficult. J still developed intelligent spot welding as shown in the figure 1. To meet such requirement, hitherto spot welding has been performed at the constant electrode force and the welding current. In contrast, intelligent spot welding is the technology in which the stable nuggets are formed by the changing the electrode force and the welding current during the welding. This technology is already in the practical use. Moreover, in the welding of the high tensile strength steel, it was difficult to secure the cross tensile strength of this there. Schematic illustration of the intelligent spot welding process of the three-sheet joint. Three-sheet joint have been shown here. Of the first step is there, second step is there, electrode force is there, welding current is there, time is there. It is shown here in the figure. Joints, as the strength increases, J still developed the pulse spot welding technology to satisfy the stable joint property by controlling the segregation and the strength distribution of the welded joint. As a feature of this technology, a short time, a high voltage pulse current is applied after the main current. In conventional welding, a current pattern that utilizes the tempering effect of the high strength part by applying a temper current has long been used. In comparison with that method, the developed method makes it possible to obtain a more stable weld property in a short time. A typical pulse spot welding current pattern is found in figure 2. Recently, in addition to the new welding processes, JFE Steel has also explored an approach to improvement of the joint property by studying the controlling factors for their strength characteristics based on a fracture mechanic analysis of the resistance spot welds of the high tensile strength material. In addition to development of the unique resistance sport welding technology for the high tensile strength material, JE Steel is also engaged in the technical development for the improvement of the welding efficiency. In particular, in order to perform resistance sport welding in the automobile assembly process, it is necessary to assess the weld from the both sides of the steel sheets by applying robots to the welding. But for this, it was necessary to manage and assess route and space to the insert welding guns from the both sides. Therefore, JE Steel developed a single-site sport-resistant welding technology, which enables welding by assess from only one side. Although series types single-site sport welding methods by the two electrodes have been also studied for the many years, it was difficult to manage a stable current flow. Instead, JE Steel developed the indirect type single-site sport welding method to solve the problem. In this method, it is necessary to optimize the position of the grounding of the electrode depending on the component. But in addition to this, the electrode force and the current are also controlled during the welding as illustrated in the figure 3. Taking advantage of this feature, this is a welding technology with excellent robustness, which make it possible to suppress instability. These are the weld current pattern of the pulse spot welding. Here is the weld time is there. There is the weld current is there. Main current to form the nugget. Here, repetition of the short time high current, higher than the main current. This is given here. Condition of the single side spot welding. There is the time is given here. Electrode force is given here. Welding current is given here. First stage is given here, second stage is given here, electrode is given here, ground is given. Schematic diagram of the remote laser welding is shown here. There is the welding head with the beam scanner, scanned laser beam workpiece is shown here. It is caused by shunting as a welding technology which assesses the weld from one side. Laser welding is also an important candidate technology. Recently, a high efficiency welding technology called remote laser welding was developed thanks to the progress in the laser oscillator and the peripheral hardware such as optical system, and the technology has been applied widely both in the Japan in the other country. While many issues for the laser welding technology remain to be solved, such as the cost of the equipment, safety, countermeasure, etc., it is expected to be possible to satisfy both improved stiffness and reduced sheet thickness by application of the high tensile strength material by a changeover from point welding in resistance sport welding to the continuous liner welding. Moreover, the expanded application of the laser welding is also expected in the future by the selection of the laser welding method suited to the respective part. For example, application of the laser arc hybrid welding to the auto chassis part, remote laser welding to the door area, etc. Status of the technical development in plate and the steel pipe fields. Due to the increasing scale of the structure in the steel welding and the construction field in the recent year, adoption of the high strength and the heavy thickness in the steel material used in those structures is progressing. In the shipbuilding fields, upscaling of the container ship has progressed to the 18 TU. Considering efficiency, in transportation of the long distance cargo, container capacity converted to the 20-foot container unit. Similarly, there is an orientation toward the design reaching 80 to 100 mm in thickness of the high strength steel. Therefore, the two electrode gauge welding is now applied to the hedge side combing and the similar parts of the ship that had been welded in one pass by the conventional large heat input welding and the low heat input multi-layer welding by the CO2 arc welding is inherently used welding of the longitudinal stiffeners. However, two electrode EGW requires an increased heat input advanced welding technology. On the other hand, various problems also arise in the multi-layer CO2 arc welding, including increased welding time and the cost. To solve this problem, the development of the narrow gap welding technology, which makes it possible to reduce the heat input and the improved welding efficiency, has been promoted as the JSTAR-TM welding. Which is a type of the CO2 arc welding is one such effort. However, the JSTAR welding realizes drop load transport in a spray form, enabling deep penetration welding with a minimal splitter, and thus is an optimal method for the narrow gap welding. Figure 5 shows the setup of the JSTAR welding, in contrast to the electrode positive welding, which has been used until now. The opposite polarity, electrode negative, is adapted in the JSTAR welding. A wire with the trace amount of the rare earth metal as an arc stabilizer is used, because the JSTAR welding utilizes a conventional welding power source and enables narrow gap welding simply by the selection of the proper welding wire. Low cost, high efficiency welding is possible. Moreover, due to the smaller number of the welding passes and decrease in the amount of the welding, application to the heavy gauge plate is considered possible in the sectors of the building and the bridge construction. Electroslag welding is used in the welding of the diaphragm of the box column, which is considered necessary in the sector of the building construction. Low heat input multi-layer welding is difficult to apply this work. Illustration of the setup of the JSTAR welding. This is the steel plate, nozzle is there, CO2 gas is there, wire feeder roller is there, JSTAR welding wire is there, welding power supply is there, power cable is there, drop rod is there, arc is there, molten pool is there. This is the illustration of the setup of the JSTAR welding. As plate thickness increases, ultra-large heat input welding becomes unaffordable. As a result, it is difficult to obtain stable weld metal property. Since dilution of this metal is large, it is important to adjust the composition of the welding wire and the flux correspond to the condition, but composition adjustment of the solid wires requires time and increases cost. Given this situation, technical development was carried out to enable quick low-cost composition adjustment corresponding to the welding condition by using an ESW wire as a metal cored wire design. Elements that cannot be added stably in the solid wire can be added easily by this MCW design, and stabilization of the property of the weld metal of the ESW is possible with extra thick material. Ministerial approval has already been obtained for these wires, and final tests have been carried out by aiming at the practical application range. Regarding technical development in the field of the steel pipe, the following introduces a multiple electrode submerged arc welding method that can be applied to the welding of the longitudinal seam of the welded pipe, as performed in the UAE pipe manufacturing process. In recent years, there has been a high need for the heavy wall thickness, high strength steel pipe. As a result, the welding process has become the rate determining step in the manufacturing process, and decreased toughness of the heat affected joint due to the excessive heat input and other negative effects have become a concern. Hitherto, the composition of the base metal and the weld metal have been designed to be suitable for the large heat input welding, and a study centered on the large heat input high speed welding by the multiple electrode SO2. However, as shown in the schematically in figure 6, it is possible to increase penetration depth and the deposition efficiency even with the same welding current by using a small diameter wire which had not been studied in the past. Based on this, a heat input saving SO2 technology which enables efficient welding was developed by increasing the degree of freedom in control effect of the wire diameter on the penetration depth and the deposition rate. These are the figure as is shown here. Diameter of the wire is there, penetration depth is there, penetration depth and the deposition rate is given there. deposition rate is given there. Shape of the weld, as a result, it becomes possible to give the ideal welding bead and the ideal high-speed welding technology for heavy thickness material, which can also suppress the occurrence of the welding defects could be developed. Current status of the basic technology development. Since the 1970, much research has been devoted to the microstructure control of the weld metal. Microstructure control in the TIB system was by an ocular ferrite microstructure was considered optimal and has been widely applied in order to achieve high toughness. However, the formation mechanism of that microstructure has still not been clarified, and it is currently applied by the empirical phenomenology. Although various studies have been carried out up to now, new knowledge continues to be obtained by utilizing state-of-the-art observation technique, for example, techniques for the identifying the inclusion that ocular ferrite form by the direct observation of the ocular ferrite formation process by the high temperature laser scanning confocal microscope, and the detailed analysis of their structure and detailed analysis of the crystal orientation relationship of the inclusion and the ferrite and austenite. This kind of the basic study and the other important study related to the welded joint are reviewed in the following. As particular issue, technique for the improving fracture and the fatigue property of the stress concentration at the weld toe are important, and a variety of the study have examined this issue up to the present improvement of the heat affected joint property by composition design of the steel weld material has been used as a technique for improving the fracture property of the weld. However, non-brittle fracture welding method has developed as a technique for the improving performance from the welding process. In the NBU method, the toughness of the heat affected joint around the weld toe is improved by applying ingenuity to the pass sequence and the heat input in the final year of the multi-layer welds. Where the fatigue characteristics of the weld are concerned due to the tensile residual stress and the stress contraction in the weld toe, it was not possible to improve the fatigue strength of the joint if the strength of the base metal was increased, and this was a large barrier to the use of the high strength material. What was studied in response to this problem was a method for controlling the smooth bed shape so as to mitigate stress concentration in the weld toe by a new welding technology and the pinning treatment to the smoothen the bed shape after welding and the give compressive residual stresses to the parts where tensile residual stresses was present. In a hybrid welding technology for plasma welding of the J-star welding may be mentioned as an example of the former. Conversely, the quality of the plasma electrode and the CO2 arc welding electrode were opposite, and it was difficult to control the bead shape due to the repulsion between the plasma and the arc. However, by use in the combination with the electrode negative J-star welding, a smooth weld bead toe shape is easily obtained, and it is possible to improve fatigue characteristics. On the other hand, if it is possible to control the toe shape only in the hammer pinning, the workload in the welding is similar to that of the grinder treatment, and for that reason alone, no large merit can be obtained. However, the hammer pinning also has the effect of introducing residual compressive stress. The technique of the hammer pinning on the base metal was developed, making maximum use of the effect of introducing residual compressive stresses, and the application of the actual bridge has begun. In quality assurance of the weld, visualization technology was applied to the electric resistance welded pipe, and a study was carried out by the phased array ultrasonic testing method. In visualizing technology, direct observation of the molten pool has been performed by using the high-speed camera, which have been widely used in the observation of the welding phenomena in recent years. And the reliability of the weld has been improved by optimization of the welding condition based on the results of that observation. Moreover, a quality assurance technology for welds has been established by utilizing the phased array technology, which makes it possible to apply online inspection technology with sensitivity more than the 10 times higher than in the past. Since this technology are applicable to the arc weld, laser weld, and other types of the weld, further development can be expected in the future. Fixed and stir welding appears as a recent technology, as a welding technology, fusion welding, implying arc, laser, and other methods have been investigated in the research here too, and much technical development has been carried out. However, this is the schematic diagram of the hammer pinning of the base metal. Depression by the hammer pinning, air tool is there, pin is there, weld metal is there, base metal is there. This is the microstructure of the friction stir welding. Weld center is there, stir zone is there, heat affected zone is there, thermally mechanically affected zone is there, base metal is there, retreating side is there, advancing side is there. This is the weld center. Arise when applying the complex phenomena that occur accompanying melting and damage at the heat affected zone to the joining of the high tensile strength steel and dissimilar material. Therefore, which is a non-fusion joining method has attracted attention as a new technology. Because tool durability is a problem in this joining technology, today practical application had centered on low melting point metal such as aluminum and the like. However, with progress in the tool development, research now advanced also to the steel material. In particular, studies have been carried out on the application of the SWW to the high tensile strength steel sheets for the automotive application. And expansion of the range of the joining condition under which strength can be obtained stably can be seen. On the other hand, in the field of the thick plates, study of the application of the girth welded joint of the UAE pipe has been begun. Butt welded joints have been fabricated with the plate thickness of the 12 mm as shown in the photo one. And the detailed study of the microstructure toughness evaluation extra is underway. Since the FSW is a non-fusion method, it has large merits from the viewpoint of the weldability, in that defects such as blowholes, residual stresses, and the welding distortion extra are surfaced, and the welding process does not generate sputter, fume, or the slag. High expectation are placed on the future practical application in the joining of the dissimilar material, including suppression of the formation of the intermetallic compound, which have a large negative effect that can be seen at the bonded interface. Trend in the welding automotive technology in the actual fabrication. JE Engineering produces a wide range of the welded structure product, including the industrial machinery such as the engine, turbine, shielded drilling machine, and the cranes, and the social infrastructure product such as a bridge, coastal structure, and the water pipe. Field welding has also become a key technology for the laying pipelines and railway rails and construction of the various types of the plants. This chapter introduces four welding automation technology developed by the JE Engineering and unmanned robot welding system, narrow gap welding for the extra thick sheet metal plate, field welding for the pipeline and the rail welding, and reviews the transition of the technology and the recent trends. Unmanned robot welding system, TSU work, JE Engineering introduced a full-scale unmanned robot welding system by multi-articulated robot in 1992 as a part of the changeover to line production of the bridge and coastal structure. The high-speed rotating arc welding process, which was developed independently by the JE Engineering, was applied in these robots, and a large improvement in the productivity and the quality stabilization were achieved thanks to this outstanding high current, high speed weldability, and the arc sensor. At the time of the introduction, the object was past horizontal period will join, how you are as a result of the subsequent technical development, its range of the application was expanded to the vertical and inclined joint and further to the multi-layer fully prepassion joint. As a result of a review of the robot axis configuration, development of a compact rotating torch, development of a simple teaching function, and the other improvement, its range of the application was expanded from the simple flat welded panels to the complex three-dimensional structure. A recent example of the actual application, 4202, showed a gouging lace full penetration and weld joint and drawvolt welding as a breakwater panel. Narrow gap welding of the heavy plate. Commercial portable rectangular coordinate robots are applied to the welding of the grooved multi-pass welded joints of the thick plate. However, in the case of the extra thick plate with the thickness exceeding 100 mm, the amount of the deposited material becomes extremely large and decreased toughness is a problem in the high strength steel. Narrow gap welding with a square parallel groove is an effective solution to this problem. J Engineering developed the narrow gap welding process with high speed rotating arc in the 1980s and has applied this technology to recent application in the unmanned robot building. Principle and application of the narrow gap welding. This is the rotation motor, welding wire, braking block, electrode nozzle, contact tip. Thick plate products such as steel frames, bridges, parts for the heavy machinery, etc. The principle of this welding process and an example application are shown figure 8. Welding efficiency and quality have improved greatly in comparison with the conventional technology as a result of the application of the tandem unmonitored welding method and the development of an adaptive control function for the welding speed responding to changes in the groove width. A circular welding function was also added, thereby expanding the range of application to inclined and other asymmetrical joint and efforts to reduce the groove width from the 13 mm to the around 8 mm and minimize welding distortion are the now underway. Field girth welding of the gauge pass line. In comparison with the soft welding described above, field welding of the gas pipeline is performed in a safer work environment and also has the high quality requirement. And for this reason, acceptance of the automatic welders in the field was delayed. However, in the late 90s, the viability of the automatic welder improved. Compact design were developed and large diameter heavy thickness pipe were adopted in the gas pipeline. Accompanying these changes, the number of the joints in the which the automatic welders were used increased rapidly by more than 4 times in approximately 5 years, and the automation rate of the high pressure main pipeline exceeded 80%. At present, the automation rate is the nearly 100%. In response to the trend toward the large diameter heavy wall thickness pipeline, all company involved in the welding work have taken on the challenge of the high efficiency by the simultaneous inside-outside welding and the square group narrow gap welding method. But due to the field workability of these methods and the complexity of the group preparation work, they did not become established in the field welding. Accordingly, later reports focused on the improvement of the existing machine. Photo 3 shows an example of application of the high efficiency welding method using the two torches. Photo 3A shows a two-head method in which the two welding carriage move in parallel in the same direction on the same rail. However, because the interval between the carriage is changed by changing their speed depending on the welding position. Application of this method is limited to a large diameter pipe of the certain size. On the other hand, we saw a dual torch method which developed recently. The range of the application has been extended to the smaller diameter pipe and operation and monitor have been simplified, making this an extremely practical technology for the field welding. rail welding technology, JE engineering, rail welding technology have been extensive track record, which include Japan's Shinkage and the express conventional lines operated by the Japan Railway Company, subway and the private railway lines. Rail welding consists of the three welding operation: primary welding, in which the short rails are made up in the swap into the long rails with lengths of the 100-200; secondary welding, in which the length of the rail is extended to the approximately 1 kilometer in the field; and tertiary welding, in which the final laying or the rail extent is the performed at the site. Primary welding is performed by the face welding, and the secondary welding is done by the gas pressure welding. The main technique for the tertiary welding are the enclosed arc welding and the thermit welding. JE Rail Link not only performs secondary and the tertiary welding as a welding contractor, but also sells flash welding machines to the railway company. This technology offers high welding efficiency with a flash welding time of the about 1.5 to the 4 minutes, which is shorter than that by the other joining method, and is also excellent in terms of the quality, stability, and the welding management. The principle of the flash welding and a rail welding machine are shown in the figure 9. This machine is a lightweight, portable machine designed for the use at the field basis in the construction of the Horiko line in the preparation for the Winter Olympic Games in the Nongo. This technology supports the rapid speed of work for the 50 or more rails per day. Recently, a new low-cost, compact, lightweight type was developed in the renewable fixed type machine at the rail center. This technology offers a combination of the high efficiency and the power saving thanks to a unique control system and is demonstrated its effectiveness in welding of the long rail. Principle and portable machines of the flash welding have been shown here. Pro flash process, flash process, offset process have been shown here. Conclusion: this paper has presented an overview of the recent trends in the development of the welding technology in the JE Group by reviewing the typical technology in the automotive material field and the plate and steel pipe field. Trends in the basic research on the microstructure of the weld metal, which was continued from an early date technology progress by the welding method, which are being promoted from the viewpoint of the fatigue and the fracture of the weld, and recent quality control technology for the welds or joining technology were also introduced. These technology have already reached the level of the practical application, and their application is necessary and indispensable presence as the major key technology when the responding to the strict requirement placed on the steel material. JE Steel is engaged in technical development on a daily basis in order to supply advanced steel products and state of the art use technology to the customers. JE Engineering is endeavoring to achieve higher efficiency in the welding to secure a stable quality in a diverse range of the steel structure product. This paper introduced 4 examples of the welding automation technology which were developed independently by the JE Engineering, because welding is a critical technology which holds the key to the safety of the social infrastructure, industrial machinery, and energy related products. The company is putting great effort into the technical development in order to create the foundation for a safe and secure life. The JE Group is confident that progress in the development of this welding and the joining technology, use technology, and automation technology in the group will enhance global technological competitiveness and will also contributing to the society. The references are given. References are given here. Seto Kojiro, Journal of the Society of Automatic Engineers, Japan. Masumura Ikeda, Taguchiki, Sadhi, Matsusa, Yogisika, Yogisakawa, Kowashi, Suzuki, Kakuta, Hekka, Isinga, Tascada, ओमारियो मसन्या मोरिकेज इजुका मस्कुलिता सुगितानी सुगितानी सुगितमेजी एंड यागमोतो दीज आर द रेफरेंसेस गिवन इन द पेपर दीज आर द रेफरेंसेस गिवन इन द पेपर